I grew up with a piano, which I always thought came from the Knockjohn ship, that went aground on the Thames estuary in Christmas 1848. You know, it's kind of fascinated me. I didn't know the name of the ship, I didn't know when it had happened or anything other than that maybe this German piano had come from the ship. It just fascinated me, finding things at the bottom of the sea, things that have been lost or, you know, I think it's quite a childlike fascination with hidden treasure, bringing them to the surface and recycling them.
Artists are often likened to being like fishermen. They, through their skill and hard work and patience, they bring to the surface the creatures that move around underneath the surface, like creatures of the subconscious. They bring them to the surface and make them visible. I make pictures of the things which I think are important. I mean, the working waterfronts of various places. Personally, I feel that to make a living as an artist, I need to feel secure and part of a community and feel that I belong and that I have roots in the area. I mean, I think all of my sort of interest in history is part of what feeds me as an artist.
The working aspect of a community is its heart. It's what made Wivenhoe and Brightlingsea distinct from other places, was that they built ships. This is what's left of James and Stone's shipyard. Many years ago I worked on the slipway here on a big Baltic trader, corked her from one end to the other. It's rather sad what's left of it now.
The connecting thread in James's work isn't so much a straight line, it is a curve. I think his art avoids the straight line. And he curves everything, really.
This was the first circular view of a town, Wivenhoe. And that was Wivenhoe past and present. I've put the shipyard back, I've put the port back. I've put buildings back to how I would like them.
I think his career does sort of echo that momentum of the arc, which to me is a movement to go forward, but also to go back to your beginnings. I think James's career does that too, because he began as a shipwright and went on to many other things as a trainee artist, but has come back fully to portraying ships. And I think his career does sort of echo that momentum of the arc, which to me is a movement to go forward, but also to go back to your beginnings.
At art school, a lot of my thoughts were about, you know, am I an artist, am I a shipwright? You know, what do I want to do? How do I want to spend my life? The enjoyment and excitement of the shipyard and the enjoyment of life as an artist. You know, which one am I? Really, I saw at that time the struggle between a kind of man-made, logical cubist kind of carpenter and a sort of Renaissance classical angel, and that struggle between the material and the spiritual. I think in a way by polarizing it, I saw it as a kind of stuck position rather than a creative one. Carpenter wrestling with an angel as where creativity is born.
I think your hands are more sensitive than your eyes sometimes. In some ways, an idea isn't proven until you've made it, until you've made that idea with using your hands.
This is a woodcut of the inside of the Pioneer looking aft. Very similar to the view I've done with paintings.
I often do paintings of people working, doing things. I want to celebrate the work of shipwrights and the physicality of things. I think it's very sad that skills are less and less valued, and that, you know, the trades are disappearing.
Traditional boat building is not a craft that's continued very much anymore. Pioneer is part of a fleet of deep sea smacks that were bigger than any other fleet in the country, and therefore she needed to be restored.
James Dodds comes down here quite a lot with his camera and his sketch pad, and you often find him just curled up in the corner, sketching away.
His medium of art is great for us in promoting Pioneer. It's just, we're not just promoting to the sailing world, we're promoting to the art world, in that Pioneer has been like a sculpture or a changing sculpture from day one when it came out. Well, it was a sculpture in the mud and it came out of the mud, and that's continually changed. And it's changing every day now.
I like his lino prints. He did one two-tone lino print in particular we've used quite a lot, which is of Sean, the little guy at the back there, spiraling a plank down this side of the boat on the outside. And it's just